Now we take you.
Coming up on this edition of RPM Tonight, can Alex Zanardi squeeze out his fourth straight win? Or will he have to dodge a few obstacles? It'll take a sharp character to overcome the attrition rate in Dover as the Monster Mile earns its nickname. The rookies are turning up the heat in Fontana, but they'll have some cagey veterans to contend with as the points battle tightens up. The NHRA is breaking out the ammunition at the Mile High Nationals. Hang in there. RPM Tonight is next.
Welcome, race fans. This is RPM Tonight. Winston Cup and F1 took the weekend off, but we're working. We've got DGN in California, the NHRA in Denver, the IRL on the Monster Mile. We'll get you completely up to speed in only 30 minutes. Today's Molson Indy Toronto was a race filled with firsts. Dario Franchitti was the first driver ever to capture back-to-back pole positions at the street course in Toronto. Starting next to him in row one, Alex Zanardi, trying to become the first kart driver since Al Unser Jr. in 1990 to win four consecutive races. Also in the field, Michael Andretti, who's finished first in this event five times, to the streets of Toronto, and things were tight early. On board with Andretti, Gilles DeFerrin trying to sneak by on the outside. DeFerrin locks up. Andretti hangs on to the third spot. Pole sitter Dario Franchitti in control early, leading Andretti and Jimmy Vassar following. From the rear camera of Scott Pruitt, no place to pass in Toronto. Very tight street course. Richie Hearn finds that out the hard way. He cannot get past. Lap 28, Alex Baron trying the inside on Michel Jourdain. Baron locks up his brakes and gets underneath them. Then you're on board with Zanardi. Looking up at teammate Jimmy Vassar, they almost tires. They avoid and they continue. Lap 62, Tony Kanaan in the pits in fifth place, trying to take off with the gas hose not disconnected. There's a fire, but nobody was hurt. Franchitti continues his dominance. Zanardi and Andretti battling for second. Andretti eventually holding off Zanardi. On lap 66, Walter Salas trying the inside line on Little Al, and Salas locks him up and flips. He'll be okay. Lap 80, the leader, Franchitti. His brakes fail and he spins out going around the corner. His crew in shock. How can this be? You're on board with Andretti again, flying around the corner and just missing Dario. Good driving. Andretti takes over the lead. Watch it again. Franchitti dead stop. Andretti goes right in front of him. And then Vassar goes right over the nose. And Zanardi goes behind him. Less than five laps to go. Paul Tracy's troubles continue. He locks up and hits Adrian Fernandez. Three laps to go. Andretti getting too deep in the turn. Look at the move by Zanardi. Daring. Gutsy. He takes the lead. And check it out. On board with Zanardi. Nobody in front because he's your winner. Indeed, the first driver since Little Al in 1990 to win four races in a row. Squeezing out five-time Toronto champion Michael Andretti with three laps to go. Target Chip Ganassi teammate Jimmy Vassar third. Bobby Rahal, who won the first ever Toronto race in 1986, was fourth. They were followed by Brian Herta, Scott Pruitt, Richie Hearn, pole sitter Dario Franchitti recovered and finished 20th, but Zanardi gets his 14th career win with a gutsy move.
Alex Zanardi does not lack for first-place finishes this year, but for the past 2 years, you finished second here. You made it exciting here to win this one.
Absolutely, Mello. I'm obviously really happy. I think I won a race that I thought I had already lost big time, and when I was fourth and I had no brakes left, no bite at the front left, I kept locking the rear wheels, and on top of everything, the pedal was going down. So a couple of times, I found myself in a very risky situation. Then I got the yellow. It was like the cat's meow, exactly what I needed. And I got the brake back, and it all worked. You know, I got the tires to do the job at the end, and Michael was a little bit in trouble. It worked fine.
Keep winning these races. You're not letting anyone back into this championship, huh, Alex?
Well, I know. And I feel sorry in a way because, I mean, I look at Michael and I say, I'm sorry, you know, but at the end of the day, what can I do? I'm just doing my job. If I see the opening, why shouldn't I take advantage? That's my job, you know, try to win races, and that's what I try to do. I got the car, I got the team. Chip today did a great job, really saved me when Dario spun me, told me right away to stay on the ride. I got the luck on my side, I got everything.
And our thanks to Marlo Klein. You'll hear more from her a little bit later on in the show. To say that Alex Zanardi has been dominant this year on the kart circuit is an understatement. With eight races to go, he could easily surpass the kart record of eight wins in a season. He has only one finish outside the top this year. More reactions from those who followed him in Toronto.
When we went in under braking, my rear's locked hard, and you know, he just had a run on me, and I tried to not give him too much room. We went pretty close, and you know, he took advantage.
Last year I made a mistake, you know, and I hit the wall after, you know, the first corner, and last year was my fault. This year I don't know what I could have done to avoid it. You know, there's nothing I could have done to stop the car going around, you know, and the problem was it was intermittent all day. I just feel really sorry for my guys.
Alex Zanardi retains his points lead with the victory at Toronto. His teammate Jimmy Vassar leapfrogging into second place in the points with a third place finish. He trails Zanardi by 69 points with eight races left. Later on in the show, more from Marlo Klein in Toronto. We'll answer the question, what happened to Dario Franchitti and his shot at nearly 400 grand? There was much trepidation among the IndyCar set about racing at Dover Downs this weekend. The Monster Mile features 24-degree bankings and a very sticky, very fast concrete racing surface. But entering today's Pep Boys 400K, IRL points leader Tony Stewart was playing it cool, saying, quote, the cars are comfortable to drive. This from the man who qualified 30 miles an hour faster than the Dover Downs track record. The real thing came today, and the flag man would get his money's worth. The caution on lap 22 because Jeff Ward hammered the wall in turn four. Scott Goodyear gets caught up in the wreck, hits some debris, and then hits Jack Miller. Goodyear's car hitting the inside retaining wall. The Pennzoil team, though, getting it done on this afternoon. They take off the nose, put a new one on, and Scott Goodyear is back in the race. Meanwhile, Tony Stewart and Scott Sharp running up front. Sharp runs down on the apron of the track and almost loses control. A good save by Sharp, and he would stay in the race. Lap number 96, fourth caution of the day, and Sam Schmidt decides to pay all of you a visit at home. Knocks off the camera and knocks himself out of the race at the same time. Caution number five would come later. And yes, he was still earning his money. Greg Ray on the inside battling with Eddie Cheever for fourth place. They touch. Ray sending Cheever up into the wall. Ray subbing for the injured Billy Boat. Cheever, the Indy 500 champion. Both drivers upset with each other. An end to a frustrating day.
Make that fourth place.
On a track like this, especially when you're in traffic, you pass high, you pass low, you pass every chance you get. So when there was a group, there was an opportunity to go around the outside. I took it. I got all the way around on a straight, and all of a sudden I got hit from behind. And
you touch cars here. That's what happened. I've got $400,000 of damage to somebody who didn't use his head. But anyway.
It's very unfortunate. We both had good cars. We both could have been contenders, but I was faster. He should have just got in behind me, and you know, we could have chased Tony down.
Ouch, babe. Tony Stewart had suspension problems. They had to remove the entire suspension, put a new one in, and he still finished in eighth place. Lap 203. Yeah, he's still working. 1997 Indy 500 winner Ari Leyendijk. His engine just conks out. He goes for a spin. Leyendijk finding the wall. Back to the business of racing. Buddy Lazier running second, trying to track down Scott Sharp. But Sharp, too tough. And congratulations to him. He picks up his second victory of the season. A war of attrition won by Scott Sharp. His second victory this year, also a winner in Phoenix. Buddy Lazier, Marco Greco, and Davey Hamilton following Sharp. Fully half of the field taken out of the Monster Mile by crashes or mechanical failure. Seven cautions, 99 laps. Only 10 cars of 22 were running at the end of the race. But Sharp stayed sharp for his third career IRL win.
We're in a points race. We got to finish. I think that played a little bit into maybe some of the decisions I made today and tried to keep it out of trouble, but certainly wanted to lead as much as we could. You can see why they call it the Monster Mile. I mean, this place is awesome fast, and it's really a neat place to run, but its defining characteristic is how rough it is. I mean, it's nasty rough.
I don't know exactly what was wrong. We just had a failure that, you know, tried to drive the car to the wall and kept it off the wall, came in, made the change, and went back out.
Scott Sharp vaulting past Tony Stewart in the point standings by virtue of the victory. Stewart had to replace his entire suspension in the race. Still finished eighth. Davey Hamilton maintaining his third place standing with a top five finish at Dover Downs. Scott Goodyear is fourth and Buddy Lazier fifth. The IRL has five more events left on the schedule. Charlotte coming up next weekend. A little curveball in the midst of RPM tonight. All year long, Bobby Hillen's number 8 Chevrolet has been receiving periodic updates to its rear quarter panel and bed cover. Hillen has a baseball decal on which his clean shower team keeps track of Mark McGwire's home run. Big Mac is a partner in the team. On Saturday, the number was changed to 42 after McGwire went deep twice on Friday night. Today, all the BGN drivers looking for the home run as they hit the track at the California Speedway for the Kenwood 300, and we've got some issues early. Michael Waltrip, the 21 car, losing control on turn number 4 of lap number 2. The in-car cam from Lance Hooper showing how he avoids it by going for a drive in the park. Waltrip finishing 23rd. Dale Earnhardt Jr. took over the lead. At one part, he was 6 seconds up on the pack. Lap 100, Todd Bodine, the 30 car, driving on his axle. His crew had failed to tighten a lug nut during a previous stop, so he drives in without a tire. He finished 33rd. His tire finished 44th. Lap 106, Busch Series point leader Mike McLaughlin touching a car and causing the bulge in the bumper. He had to make a pit stop, a costly break. He was 4th then. He would finish 23rd. Less than 40 laps to go. Kevin LePage on Earnhardt's tail trying to take the lead, and said he takes the wall, and that's as close as he could get as Junior. Was too tough. Little Dale winning his 4th event in his last 13 races. His 4th Busch Grand National victory overall. He led 141 of 150 laps. He beats out Kevin LePage and Matt Kenseth. Phil Parsons 4th, David Green, the only non-Chevy in the top 5. The rest of the top 10 on the day. This was the 19th of 31 races on the Busch Grand National schedule. Dale Jr. carving out a name for himself on the junior circuit. He's with Bill Weber.
Well, here's a familiar position, Dale Earnhardt Jr. in victory lane again. Congratulations.
I appreciate that, Bill. We had an excellent race car. Hutter engines tired us all the way down the straightaways all day long. Nothing could really touch the car on the straightaways. And Tony Earn and the guys put a good setup under the car that made my job pretty easy.
Don't take this the wrong way. You don't have a lot of experience. How can you be that good at these tracks?
Tony and the guys have just been doing this for so long, and he's raised Tony Jr., his son, to be a great shock specialist. The boy is cut crew chief material.
Friday, you said this is the first time you've really been thinking about points, and now you have the lead again.
Yeah, we got on top there one time, and it just was too young and too inexperienced to know what I had when I had the points lead. And
you're a lot older now, huh?
Yeah, well, just a lot more wiser, I believe, and I know how valuable it is, and I know what every point's worth, and they're worth a whole bunch. They're worth a lot. And good head of points lead back. We want to just hang on to what we got and continue our string of top tens. We got like 7 in a row, I think, now. And that's what's going to win the championship.
Well, we talk about how California has always been the land of opportunity. Dale Earnhardt Jr. took that opportunity to grab Busch Series win number 4 this season.
Dale Jr.'s 4 wins have come in the last 13 races, and he takes over the series points lead. He is 6 up on Matt Kenseth. Mike McLaughlin led the standings coming in today, but he had mechanical problems. He finished 24th. Randy LaJoy trying to become the first BGN driver ever to win 3 straight championships, but he is 348 points behind with 12 races to go. If you stay seated with seatbelts securely fastened, we've got Winston Cup news coming up on deck, some personnel changes to tell you about. And after we go in circles, we'll head for the straight lines of the NHRA Mile High Nationals in Denver. Drag racing coming up. Also coming up, Dale Jarrett won it last year at Pocono. Who will take it this year? Some insight from Benny Parsons.
Was traveling southbound.